I like a new Lincoln with all of its class. I like a martini and bird under glass. I'm gonna start living. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. I like to eat lobster directly from Maine. I like to see bullfights in sunny old Spain. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Tally-ho, off we go. Who can wait another day? You and me out on a spree. Let's get started right away. We're gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We'll visit a palace and dine with a king. We're gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Let's get started right away. We're gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We'll visit a palace and dine with a king. We're gonna start living. You just wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough. With all of its class, I like a martini and bird under glass. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. I like to eat lobster directly from Maine. I like to see bullfights in sunny old Spain. I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Tally-ho, off we go. Who can wait another day? You and me out on a spree. Let's get started. We'll visit a palace and dine with a king. We're gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. Thank you. gonna go a traveling and a have us a fling. We'll visit a palace and dine with a king. We're gonna start living, you just wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. I like a new Lincoln with all of its class. I like a martini and birds in the glass. Nothing but the best is good enough for me. I like to eat lobster directly from Maine. I like to see bullfights in sunny old Spain. I'm gonna start living, you wait and see. Another day, you and me out on a spree. Let's get started right away. We're gonna go traveling and have us a fling. We'll visit a palace.
When you told me how old you were then, I didn't believe you. I actually asked her to show me her driver's license. So everyone, I want you to take notice. I think Darlene has found the fountain of youth. And it wasn't in a pill, and it wasn't in a cream, but it was in her volunteering. So everybody, when Darlene started volunteering at Tracy Interfaith Ministries, we were still on Holly Street, on the Holly Street location. That was before Y2K, 9/11, and the housing crisis in 2008. We knew we needed a bigger building before all of that and started to plan for it. Gene Shipman was retiring as director, and the board was trying to come up with a plan to fill her position then, when Darlene said she'd like to try it for a couple of years. I think God chuckled too when she said that. There was even a time when I remember, Jack, I think you probably remember it too, when she actually submitted a formal letter of resignation to the board. We laughed at that too, but well, we took it, but you know, this is 19 years later. Darlene was instrumental in designing the building we are now in, and worked tirelessly to see this project to completion. And that was not an easy process. It went on for a very long time, and she never lost the enthusiasm, she never lost the drive to keep us all motivated with the fundraising and everything else. Not everybody could do that, because there were a lot of us that kind of, oh gosh, is it ever gonna end? But it did finally with the completion of a beautiful building. I could go on and on about all the ideas that Darlene was instrumental in implementing at the food bank and within our community, but we would be here at least until midnight, and I'm sure even at that I would forget things. But mentioning these two things I think will summarize her time at Interfaith. In 2010, she was honored as Citizen of the Year, and before that, in 2004, she accepted the award for Tracy Interfaith Ministries Organization of the Year. You left us with big shoes to fill. They were so big. They were so big, it's taken three people to fill them. But as always, God has blessed us, and he blessed us with Linda Gleason, with Diana, or everybody is, Diane Ruiz, and Amy Scudder, have stepped up to all help tag team this new position of director. This tag team will continue in the footsteps of both Gene Shipman and Darlene Quinn. But Darlene, I have to tell you, there are a few things that we must insist that you agree on before your retirement is official. Number one, under no circumstances are you to move without leaving a forwarding address. Number two, you must promise never to change your phone number without first giving us the new number. And number three, this one's very important. You must agree that for at least the next 5 years, you will not open a new food bank in our area. That will be a direct competition with Tracy Interfaith Ministries. Darlene, I know you didn't. Did you want to say something?
Yeah, I just want to say, you have my promise.
I kind of figured that was a shoe, and that was Linda's idea, wherever Linda is. Darlene, I know you didn't want this retirement party and that you had hoped to just ride off into the sunset. But as Linda Gleason said, we needed to do this for us. To show you in some small way how much we at Interfaith and those representing our community appreciate you and all you've done. Anyway, I'm not sure how we got you on that horse to begin with. In closing, Here it comes. In closing, none of us can equal the amount of time you have given this organization. I can only imagine the mansion that God will have waiting for you with a huge sign that says, "Well done, my good and faithful."
Best is good enough for me.
Thank you, Renee, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Bob Elliott, County Supervisor, District 5, and it's my pleasure to be here tonight to participate in the It's my pleasure to be here tonight to participate in recognizing the tremendous service that Darlene Quinn has provided to the city of Tracy and the surrounding residents over the past 19 years. Now, we all know what a generous city Tracy is in providing food, clothing, other services to those who are in need, but it needs someone to organize that generosity, and that's what Darlene has done for these past 19 years. And as we heard, she's done such a great job of it, it's gonna take three people to do what she has done by herself for the past 19 years. So at this time, it's my pleasure to present a Board of Supervisors Certificate of Recognition to Darlene Quinn, Executive Director, Tracy Interfaith Ministries, in recognition of your 19 years of volunteering, directing, developing, and applying and administering programs assisting our community members who are in need. Your superb leadership and guidance have touched the lives of many and will leave a lasting legacy on our community. Congratulations on an honor well deserved, and best wishes in your retirement. Signed August 31st, 2018, Bob Elliott, Chairman, 5th District.
I'm gonna start living. You wait and see. Nothing but the best is good enough for me.